At its core, PowerSCADA Operation is based on another software package called SciTect SCADA. If you're already familiar with SciTect, you may be wondering where the two softwares diverge. So let's look into which skills will transfer over. At its lowest level, Studio is the same between both applications. Navigation works the same. And the SciTect add-on utilities, like the Express Wizard, are all here. However, on installation, PowerSCADA Operation comes with an extra include project called PLS Include. This contains a large amount of SciCode to enable common functions in a project, including both graphical functions and data acquisition. It also has a large number of graphics pages, legacy page templates, and genies if you use the graphics builder, but I'll discuss that more in a moment. We also have a couple of configuration tools that aren't needed for a building automation system, but make more sense in electrical power monitoring. The largest of these is Profile Editor, which allows us to build standard templates of what the different types of equipment look like and how their tags are addressed. These profiles are used by the I/O Device Manager to automatically populate the databases with devices, variable tags, alarm tags, and parameters. Think of this as the replacement for the Express Wizard. That said, the Profile Editor only supports certain protocols, so don't forget about the Express Wizard entirely. On the subject of device communications, PowerSCADA Operation also comes with the Power Modbus Driver. This allows us to perform more advanced formatting and calculations inside a single variable tag. For example, we can read the mean of several registers in a device, scale that by the value in another register, and apply an offset without any external SciCode. We also have the Application Configuration Utility, which is used to secure access to other tools that don't exist in SciTech SCADA. There are a number of options here, including login with a YubiKey one-time password. It also has a diagnostics tool for viewing and configuring device communication parameters. I mentioned that PLS Include contains some standard graphical components. While Graphics Builder is still available, we refer to that as legacy graphics because we have a separate, fully HTML5 compatible graphics engine, which uses a tool called Graphics Editor as its development environment. In addition to replacing the graphics builder, this also makes the standard SciTect thick clients and web clients obsolete, as the web HMI can be deployed automatically to any device running a modern browser. Alongside the graphics, we also have an engine running called Advanced OneLine, which allows us to change one-line bus colors based on their energized status, the sources feeding them, and indicate if they're being fed by parallel sources. This allows an operator to quickly determine the state of their network. Finally, we can integrate Power Operation with the Advanced Reports and Dashboards module, also known as Power Monitoring Expert. This gives us a full SQL-based historical database with built-in reports and running dashboards. While this is similar to SciTect Historian, the functionality is tuned to electrical monitoring, such as power quality reporting and load profiles. There are also add-on modules to advanced reports, enabling features like billing, modeling, and EPSS testing. While SciTech SCADA serves as its base, all these additional tools and features make PowerSCADA Operation ideal for usage in an EPMS. Development is faster, deployment is simpler, and the end user interface provides more utility. The upcoming video series will show you exactly how to enable all this functionality. Stay with me for more, and thank you.